Okay. So here, in different types of forces, normal reaction is one of the forces. Okay. When the body is kept on the horizontal surface and a block is kept here, then the weight, with the weight equivalent to mg, the block pushes the horizontal surface downwards. So the equivalent reaction force acts in this one. Reaction force means the force exerted by the bottom surface on the upper block perpendicular to the plane of contact. That is for normal reaction. When the block is kept on the inclined surface, then normal reaction is equal to mg cos theta. When the block is kept on the horizontal surface and it is pushed down with a force F at an angle theta with the horizontal, in this case, the normal reaction is equal to mg plus F sin theta, already said. Okay, here, because the force component F sin cos theta acts in this direction, F sin theta in this direction. That means the force component F sin theta pushes the block downwards with a force F sin theta. Already, the block pushes the horizontal surface with a force equal to gravity mg. So total force with which the block pushes the horizontal surface downwards is mg plus F sin theta. The equivalent normal reaction acts on the block upwards. That's why N is equal to mg plus F sin theta. Next, whenever the block is pulled with a force F at an angle theta with the horizontal, then when you divide this force into components, F cos theta, F sin theta acts like this. Then here on the block along vertical direction, weight mg acts downwards direction and F sin theta acts in upward direction. Even then, as the block is still in contact with the horizontal surface, means obviously mg greater than F sin theta. So net force acts on the block in downwards is equal to mg minus F sin theta. With that force, the block pushes the horizontal surface downwards. At the same time, because of reaction force, according to Newton's third law, the horizontal surface also exert the reaction force on the block upwards, which is equal to N. That's why N is equal to mg minus F sin theta. Or in other words, along vertical direction, sum of the force acts in upward direction equals sum of the forces in downwards direction. That means N plus F sin theta is equal to N plus F sin theta is equal to mg, or N is equal to mg minus F sin theta. So this is another one. Next, some more examples so we can discuss here. Suppose, fifth one, there are wedge-shaped surfaces are there like this. There are wedge-shaped surfaces are like this. Here, this is 60 degree. This angle is 60 degree. Okay, of course, it is 60 degree, these are 60 degree. That means V-shaped inclined surfaces are symmetrically with the horizontal. If the angle between these two V-shaped inclined surfaces are 60, then this is 60, this is 60. Okay, now there are two inclined surfaces are like this symmetrically. Now, a rod, here one rod is kept between the these two V-shaped inclined planes. This is the rod, or it is a block. A smooth rod of mass M. A smooth rod of mass M. Here mass of this rod is. Here mass of the rod. Mass of rod small m is equal to 10 kg is given. Mass of the rod small m is equal to 10 kg. Okay. That is kept between the walls which are fixed as shown in the diagram. Find the force exerted by wall AB. Find the force exerted by wall AB. This is AB. This is AC. Force exerted by wall AB on this rod is how much? Force exerted by rod AB on this rod means that is the normal reaction. Indirectly, they ask the normal reaction. Okay. So here, you see, the weight of the rod MG acts vertically downwards direction. Weight MG acts vertically downwards direction. Because of this weight, the rod try to comes down so that the rod pushes these two inclined surfaces away like this. But they are rigid. That's why they exert the reaction force on the rod in upward reaction force on the rod perpendicular to its plane of contact. No, this is the plane surface. This is the wall. This wall exerts the reaction force perpendicular to its surface means in this direction. This is normal reaction here. Okay. Of course, as the rod is symmetric, definitely normal action here is also same. Normal action here is also same. If it is not symmetric, normal action here and here both are different. As the rod is kept symmetrically, what is your doubt? Morning assignment, assignment solutions and okay, okay, I will send. And if possible, definitely I will try to discuss some problems because 8 problems are there, no? In 8 problems, okay, I will discuss. Okay, I will see and I will discuss them. If you are having doubt, you keep in doubt section, you keep in the WhatsApp. Otherwise, I keep the solutions in WhatsApp group. If you mention your doubts, I will keep in WhatsApp group. Okay. If possible, if time permits, definitely I will discuss here only. They are pulley type. Okay, okay. After completion of pulley only, you do. Right. Okay, you see. Here, as the rod is kept symmetrically, normal and moreover, these two inclined surfaces are symmetrically. That's why whatever the normal action exerted by this surface on the rod, this surface, the normal action exerted by this surface on the rod is also same. Now we resolve this normal reactions into components. One component in this direction, another component in this direction. Okay, if it is 60 degree, you see if it is 60, this is 60, so this is 30. So this is 60 now. Similarly, this is 60 degree. Because as these are the two horizontal lines, it is the intersecting line. If it is 60, this is 60. This is 60. As this is normal to this plane, if it is 60, it is 30. As this and this both are rectangular, okay, if it is 30, then this is 60. Now, what is the normal action component in this direction? Yes, n cos 60, and here it is n sin 60, okay? Similarly, here also, as it is 60, this is 60, okay, it is 30, and when you resolve this into components, if it is 60, this is 30, so this is 60. Now, if you resolve into components, this is n sin 60, and it is n cos 60. Suppose if this rod is not symmetrical, like this only you write, here normal action is say N1, here N2, then if you resolve this into components, N1 cos 60, N1 sin 60 like that, here N1 cos 30, N1 sin 30 like that, we can resolve. Okay, now on the rod along vertical direction, as the rod is under equilibrium because of this action of the forces, because on the rod, weight mg acts downwards and this n acts on the rod along inclination in this direction. As the rod is under equilibrium, definitely along any direction net force is zero, no? Along vertical or along horizontal, along vertical net force is zero. Along vertical Fy net is equal to zero. Fy net means sum of the force acts on the rod in upward direction equals sum of the force acts on the rod in downwards direction. Sum of the forces acts on the rod upwards means n cos 60, here n cos 60. That means 2n cos 60. 2n cos 60. That is equal to sum of the force acts on the body downwards means only one force acts on the rod in downwards direction, which is equal to its weight. Then they ask what is the normal reaction? They ask n is equal to question mark. So from this, here cos 60, these two cancel. 1 by 2, 2 cancel. Therefore, n is equal to mz. M is 10 into z is 10. Therefore, normal action is equal to 100 newton. In this way, we have to find. In this way, we have to find. Okay. So, 100 newton is the answer. Next. One more example. Okay, one more example. Today onwards, I will upload in the YouTube because it is already recording. Okay, I will upload in the YouTube from today onwards. Okay, next one more example. sixth one. There is a hollow spherical shell. Smooth. There is a hollow smooth spherical shell is there of radius Kepler. Radius Kepler. The radius is Kepler. Radius is Kepler. Okay. Here a rod of length L, which is less than 2R. Rod of length L is less than 2R. Kept on the inner walls of the spherical shell. Length is less than 2R. When it is kept on the inner walls of the spherical shell, then the rod is under equilibrium at certain position. I have shown in the figure. So rod is under equilibrium like this. This is the rod. So rod AB is under equilibrium like this. Okay, then mass of the rod is small m. So when the mass of the rod is small m, then weight always acts vertically down direction, that is equal to mg. Okay, that is given. Then normal action acts at the point of contact. So what is the normal reaction acts at the point of contact? That is the question they asked. Normal reaction acts on the rod at the point of contact. Here the inner walls of the spherical shell, with the inner walls of the spherical shell, rod is in contact with the spherical shell at this point A and at the point B also. And from the diagram, rod is symmetric about the sphere. That's why here, if you draw the normal at this point, at the point of contact, you draw the tangent to the sphere. At this point of contact, you draw the tangent to the sphere, and you draw a normal at this point of contact to this tangent. Then that is always passing through the center. On any circle, you draw a tangent, and at the point of contact, if you draw the normal, that is always passing through center. Karthik, stop your video signal. Stop your video sharing. So when you draw the normal at this point of contact, it is passing through center, say O. Here also, when you draw the normal, that is always passing through center. Every point on the surface of the sphere, if you draw the tangent and if you draw a normal line, that is always passing through center. That's why it is the normal drawn. Here it is the normal drawn. Okay. So at the point of contact, suppose if the spherical surface is not there, then this rod comes down like this. But whenever the rod comes down like this, it pushes the surface in this direction. So the reaction force exerted by the hemispherical surface on the rod at this point along the normal direction. This is the normal. That's why normal reaction acts on the rod in this direction and here. Because if you draw the tangent at this point, and you draw the normal at this point to this tangent, then you will get the, this is a normal line. So normal reaction acts in this direction. Now, suppose this is angle theta. Of course, it is also theta, because rod is symmetric about the sphere. Okay, now resolve this normal reaction into components. If it is theta, then the component adjacent to theta is cos. So that's why n cos theta, here it is n sin theta. Similarly, here also same. Here this component is n cos theta and here it is n sin theta. Okay, now when you resolve this into components, you forget these normal reactions, because these normal reactions are already resolved. So these forces are not there, only you imagine the components. Now on the rod along horizontal direction, n cos theta acts on the rod towards the right, and here n cos theta acts on the rod towards left, exactly opposite each other. That's why they cancel each other. Hence along horizontal direction, net force acts on the rod becomes zero. Okay, now along vertical direction. Suppose if normal reactions are different, if it is like this, the rod is symmetric about like this. In such case, normal reactions are also different. But rod is symmetric, that's why normal reactions are same. So along y-axis, net force along y-axis, Fy net is equal to zero. Fy net means here on the rod, along vertically upward direction, n sin theta, totally 2n sin theta force acts in upward direction and weight acts on the rod in downward direction. Even then, as the rod is equilibrium along vertical direction also, then 2n sin theta is equal to mg, or n is equal to mg by 2 sin theta. Okay, here I think values are not given. Answer is given in terms of mg, answer is given in terms of mg and L. Okay, in terms of mg sin theta, mg by 2 sin theta. Okay, it is given like this one. It is given like this one. If L is equal to R, suppose in this, if L is increasing without changing its mass, what happens? Normally, what about the normal action? If L is increasing without changing its mass, what about N value? Tell me, anybody else? Okay, Nikhil Teja, I will unmute you. You ask me your doubts. Nikhil Teja. Nikhil Teja.
Sir.
Okay, speak with me now. What is your doubt?
Ante cos theta sin theta chestunnaru kada sir.
Okay.
Ante along x axis cos theta, along y axis sin theta.
Along x axis annana angle etu vaipu untundo adu vaipu unde component pass avutundi. ఒకవేళ ఈ యాంగిల్ ఇక్కడ ఇచ్చాను అనుకో, ఇది కాస్ అవుతుంది, సైన్ అవుతుంది. ఆల్రెడీ రెజల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ వెక్టార్స్ లో చెప్పాను, అదేగా చెప్పింది రెజల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ వెక్టార్స్ లో. ఒకవేళ ఇది వెక్టార్ అయితే నార్మల్ యాక్షన్ అంటే ఫోర్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ వెక్టార్ క్వాంటిటీ. దీని కాంపోనెంట్ ఇటువైపు కన్నప్పుడు యాంగిల్ ఇటువైపు ఉంటే ఇది కాస్ తీసుకోవాలి, ఇటువైపు సైన్ తీసుకోవాలని చెప్పాను. అప్పుడు ఇది ఎంత కాస్ అయితే ఇది ఎన్ సైన్ తీటా. ఒకవేళ యాంగిల్ ఇక్కడ ఉంది అనుకో, అప్పుడు ఇది ఎన్ కాస్, ఇది ఎన్ సైన్ అవుతుంది. ఓకే రైట్. వాట్ జాక్ లివింగ్టన్ Jack Livingston, what is your doubts? Jack Livingston, okay, you tell me. Jack Livingston, you don't want to speak, you are unmuting. Again you are muting. Okay, right. Okay, you see, my question is, without changing the mass, if the length of the rod, here this length is equal to L, this length is less than 2R, that actually 2R means here, it is less than 2R means when the rod is kept inside the sphere, definitely the rod comes down and it is on the equilibrium at this position. Okay, if rod length is equal to 2R, then the rod will be here only, it will not come, rises up or comes down. Okay, suppose if the length of the rod is increasing without changing in its mass, then what about n value? You see, without changing its mass, if length of the rod increases, means when the length of the rod increases, the rod comes like this. Without changing its mass, without, it is important for advance, without change in its mass, if L value increases, if L value increases, then when L value increases, what about the theta value? When L value increases, what about theta value? Tell me. If L value increases, then the rod length increases, means the rod will be equilibrium at this place. Then theta means this angle, no? This angle theta. When the this rod comes up, then angle may decrease, no? Then theta value decreases. When theta value decreases, n is equal to mz by 2 sin theta. When theta value decreases, sin value decreases. That means in the denominator decreases without changing the mass. That's why n value will increase now. N value will increase. That means normal action exerted by the rod on the sphere. Normal action exerted by the sphere on the rod increases. Okay? That is the case. Are you understood this one? It is very, very important for advance also. Very, very important for advance also. Whenever n is equal to, whenever L is equal to 2R, when L is equal to 2R means exactly theta is equal to 0. In such case, sin 0, 0, something by 0 means infinity. So N is equal to infinity in that case, theoretically. Okay. Practically, it is maximum. Okay, next step. One more example related to normal reaction only. One more example related to normal reaction. It is a sphere it is one inclined surface. It is another inclined surface. Okay, these are the two inclined surfaces. This is one inclined surface, it is another inclined surface, smooth inclined surfaces. Okay, here the angle made by this inclined surface with the horizontal is theta 1 and here it is theta 2. That means these two inclined planes are not symmetric. The two inclined planes are not symmetric. If they are symmetric, problem becomes easy. Okay, these are not symmetric. Okay, now the problem is, what about the normal reaction exerted? This is the first inclined surface, it is the second inclined surface. What is the normal reaction exerted by this inclined surface and this inclined surface? That is the case. Normal reaction exerted by the two inclined surfaces on the sphere. The mass of the sphere is M. Mass of the sphere is M. N1 is equal to question mark, N2 is equal to question mark. We have to find the normal reactions exerted by. What is your doubt? What is your doubt? Virat, what is your doubt? Virat, what is your doubt? You tell me. Okay, here we see. Here, what is the normal reaction exerted by this inclined surface on the sphere? This inclined surface on the sphere, we have to find. That is our aim. Okay, now, what are the forces acts on the sphere? One, weight of the sphere acts always vertically downwards direction. That is mg. Where m is the mass of the sphere. M is mass of sphere. Okay, next, at the point of contact. At the point of contact, you draw a normal to the surface. At the point of contact, you draw the normal to the surface. Then, here actually, while the sphere tries to come down and pushes the inclined surface in this direction, at the same time, the inclined surface exerts the reaction force on the sphere in this direction, that is called normal reaction, N1. The normal reaction exerted by first inclined surface on the sphere is N1. Second inclined surface, it is the point of contact. At this point of contact, normal reaction exerted by the inclined surface on the sphere is normal to this one and it is passing through this center here in this direction. This is N2. Okay, now resolve this normal reactions into component. One component in this direction, another component in this direction. Similarly, here also, in this direction and in this direction. Okay, suppose if it is theta 2, this is theta 2. This is theta 2. This is 90 minus theta 2. So this is theta 2. This is theta 1, similarly. Okay. Now this component is N2 cos theta 1. Here this component is N2 cos theta, sine theta 1. Here this component is N2, sorry, it is N1. It is N1 because it is, it is N1. That's why N1. Here also N1. Here it is N2 sine theta 2. Here N2 cos theta 2. Now on this sphere, two forces N1 cos theta 1, N2 cos theta 2 acts upwards and weight mg downwards on the sphere. Even then there is no motion because this is under equilibrium. Under equilibrium, whenever this is under equilibrium, then sum of the force acts along y axis, sum of the force acts on the sphere along x axis, all are equal. Sum of the forces acts along x axis. Along x-axis, because of equilibrium, the sphere is under equilibrium. That is important. Sphere is under equilibrium. Along x-axis, net force is equal to zero. You see, on the sphere along x-axis, N2 sin theta acts in this direction, N1 sin theta 1 acts in this direction. That means they are in opposite direction. Even then, there is no motion along horizontal direction. That's why along this direction, net force is zero. That means N1 sin theta 1 must be equal to N2 sin theta 2. This is one relation. Sometimes they may ask, whenever the sphere is under equilibrium, what is the ratio between the normal reactions exerted by the two inclined surfaces? They may ask directly. n1 by n2 is equal to sin theta 1, 2 by sin theta 1. Theta 1, theta 2, you know. So we can do the problem directly. Karthik Reddy. What is our doubts? Stop your video sharing. Govana Ganna Reddy, stop your video sharing. Karthik Reddy. Is not unmuting. Okay, Virat Kohli, I will unmute you. You speak with me. You are not unmuting.
Sir?
Okay. Tell me. What is your doubt? Chepna. Chepu. Virat Kohli. Why are you meeting yourself? చెప్పనా, యువర్ వాయిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ క్లియర్. ఓకే, దేర్ ఇస్ సమ్ నెట్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. ఓకే, ఐ విల్ మీట్ యూ. There is some net problem. Your voice is completely breaking. Okay, I will mute you. Right. Okay, right. You see, directly you can join with my ID. Already send the link now. Without password, you can join. If you want to see in that ID only, if you open that ID, definitely in mobile, password is also there. You can see and you open through laptop also. Balaji Chaudhary, I think. You stop your video sharing. Balaji. Okay. Right. Along horizontal action, n1 sin theta 1 is equal to n2 sin theta 2. Sometimes they may ask directly only, what is the ratio between the normal reactions accepted? Means n1 by n2 is equal to how much? So n1 by n2 is equal to, we can write, sin theta 2 by sin theta 1, we can write like this also. Next, along vertical direction. Along vertical. Same. Along vertical concept is same. Net force along y-axis is 0. Because along vertical also it is under equilibrium. So whenever the sphere is under equilibrium, along any direction net force is 0. But along y-axis and along x-axis, in order to find the net force 0, we by making net force zero along x-axis, along y-axis, we can do the problem easily. That's why along vertical direction net force is zero. Along vertical direction on the sphere, what are the forces acts? Means n1 cos theta 1, n2 cos theta acts upwards and weight mg downwards. That's why if friction is not there, these are the smooth surfaces. If friction is there, we have considered the friction also. So n1 cos theta 1 plus n2 cos theta 2 is equal to weight mg. Okay, now suppose if you want to find n1 value, n2 should not be there. From this formula, n2 value substitute here. N1 cos theta 1 plus n2 means n1 sin theta 1 by sin theta 2. Okay, into cos theta 2 is equal to mg. Therefore, you take n1 common here. N1 of Okay, cos theta 1 into sin theta 2, you take LCM. N1 you take common and you take LCM. Then cos theta 1 into sin theta 2 plus sin theta 1 into cos theta 2 whole by sin theta 2 is equal to mg. Or N1 into, you see sin theta 1 cos theta 2 plus cos theta 1 sin theta 2 means sin theta 1 plus theta 2 you can write now. Sin theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to mg into sin theta 2. Do cross multiplication. Therefore, N1 is equal to mg sin theta 2 by sin of theta 1 plus theta 2. Of course, it is not possible to remember every formula. By this concept, you have to do. So, N1 is equal to mg sin theta 2 by sin theta 1 plus theta 2. Similarly, you find N2 value. Or in this formula, you substitute. And if you simplify them, then you will get N2 is equal to mg sin theta 1 by mg sin theta 1 by sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2, you will get. You will get this formula. These are the normal reactions in both the cases. Okay. Or in other words, by Lamy's theorem also we can do. By Lamy's theorem also we can do. Here, exactly at the same point, N1 force in this direction, N2 force in this direction, and mg in this direction acts. If by geometry, you find the angles among them, then by applying Lamy's theorem also we can do the same. We can do the problem. Okay. So we will see. You will see exactly at the point O. This is a point O. At point O, method 2. Exactly at point O, N2 acts in this direction, N1 acts in this direction, and weight mg acts vertically down this direction. If we know the angles here and here, here, everywhere, we can obtain the relation among them by using Lamy's theorem. Because according to Lamy's theorem, whenever the three vectors or three forces acts on a particle simultaneously keeps the particle in equilibrium, then the vector sum of all the forces is equal to zero, or according to Lamy's theorem, A by sin A plus B by sin B plus C by sin C is equal to A by sin A, B by sin B, C by sin C. That is equal to constant now. What is the seventh point? Vamshi Krishna, what is seventh point? What is seventh point, Vamshi Krishna? If I am unmuting, you are not unmuting. Vamshi Krishna. Password, I don't know password. Just I sent the link now. I am starting the class. How I can know? How I know the password? Vamshi Krishna, you are not unmuting. Along vertical Y, F net is equal to along vertical Y, net force is zero. Along vertical, on the sphere, there are three forces acts. N1 cos theta 1 acts vertically upwards. Already resolve this N1 into components now. One is vertical, one is horizontal. Similarly here also. So on this sphere there are two forces acts vertically upwards. N1 cos theta 1, N2 cos theta 2. Downwards only one force, weight acts. Even then along vertical direction there is no motion, means sum of the upward forces is equal to sum of the downward forces. Sum of the upward forces is N1 cos theta 1 plus N2 cos theta 2. That is equal to sum of the downward force, means only one force mg is there. I made equal. Okay. You are not unmuting. Why? Okay. Yashwant Reddy, you speak now. What is your doubt? Yashwant Reddy, come on, you speak. Hurry up. You ask me to unmute again, you are muting. Okay, right. Yashwant Reddy asked me to unmute. When I unmuted, again immediately he muted. Okay. Right, you see? Here, what about the angles? We have to find first. Suppose this is horizontal. This is horizontal. Okay. What about this angle? Suppose it is vertical. With the vertical, now N1 makes an angle theta 1. So this angle is theta 1. This angle is theta 1. This is theta 1. Okay, we know. Because with vertical, N1 with vertical, N1 makes an angle theta 1 with vertical. No? So with vertical, N1 makes an angle theta 2. Next, it is N2. With vertical, it makes an angle theta 2. So N2 also makes an angle theta 2 with vertical. Theta 2. Now, angle between these two, N1 and N2 is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2. No? That angle is known. Okay, next. What about this one? It is no doubt 90. It is 90 minus theta 2. So the total angle is 180 minus theta 2. No? 180 minus theta 2. Here it is 180 minus theta 1. Now we know three forces act on the sphere to keep it in equilibrium and the angles among them. So you apply the Lami's theorem. According to Lami's theorem, you see. N1 by sine of opposite angle. N1 by sine of opposite angle means sine 180 minus theta. Theta 2 is equal to. Okay, here. N2 by sine of opposite angle means sine 180 minus theta 1 is equal to. Mg by sine of opposite angle. Mg by sine of opposite angle means theta 1 plus theta 2 between these two forces. No? So sine of theta 1 plus theta 2. Now what about N1? N1 is equal to, from this, N1 is equal to, do cross multiplication. N1 is equal to Mg into sine 180 minus theta 2. Mg into sine 180 minus theta 2 whole by sine theta 1 plus theta 1. Theta 1 plus theta 2. Mg into sine 180 minus theta 2 means sine theta 2 by sine of theta 1 plus theta 2. We got. Same now, you see. N1 is equal to Mg sine theta 2 by sine theta 1 plus sine theta 2. We got. So it is simple method now. You can do like this also. That is by resolution of vectors method we have done. It is just by using Lami's theorem. Indeed. Similarly, N2 is equal to this into this. That means Mg into sine theta 2. Mg into sine theta 1 by sine theta 1 plus theta 2. Sine theta 1 plus theta 2. These are the formulas. In this way we can do by using Lami's theorem. I said there are uses of the basic mathematics. This is the use of basic mathematics. One part of the basic mathematics. One point in the basic mathematics. Lami's theorem. Okay. So in this way we can do. So these are the normal reactions in different cases. Okay, next tension force. Next I want to discuss the new another force. Normal reaction is one of the forces. Next tension force I want to discuss. Second one, tension force or force due to tension or simply tension or tension. Tension means the force with which the string can pull the body. The force with which the string pulls the body, that is called the tension. Vishwas Gupta Okay, Vishwas Gupta is
speaking. Sir, good morning.
Come on, tell me.
Sir, in seventh problem, we resolve N1 and N2, no, sir.
Yeah.
Why don't we resolve MG, sir?
MG is already vertically downwards, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Weight MG always acts vertically downwards, that means along y-axis. Okay, here this is x-axis. If you resolve this into x, if you resolve this...
Not like N1 direction, sir.
N1?
In N1 direction, sir.
MG in...
Why don't
we resolve N1 is in this direction.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we can resolve. We can resolve that also.
Yes, sir. But
actually, you see, it is better to resolve without confusion. It is better to resolve the given forces along x-axis and along y-axis.
Okay.
In any case, better to resolve along x-axis and along y-axis. Otherwise, we may get confusion.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Right, tension force. The force with which the string pulls the body is called the tension. Okay. So here you see one example. Suppose there are, so in order to find the tension forces, we are having connected bodies. Connected bodies. Tension force in brackets, connected bodies. Contact bodies are different, connected bodies are different. Connected bodies. First one. On a smooth horizontal surface, suppose the two blocks are kept and they are joined together by means of a string, light inextensible string. Two blocks. Here, two blocks are kept on a smooth horizontal surface. Masses of the two blocks are M1 and M2. These two are joined by means of a light inextensible string. Light means light weight, negligible mass. Inextensible, the string cannot extend. Okay. And the block M2 is pulled by means of a string with a force equal to F. Then what is the here? As it is pulled by means of a string. Suppose string is up to this. The string is held and it is pulled like this. Then whatever the force with which the string is pulled, the same tension developed here. So the tension in this string is same only. What is the force, what is the tension developed in this thing which joins the two blocks together? Here actually, this block is not pulled by us. We are pulling only this block with the help of this one. It is pulled by the string now. So with what force the string pulls this block in forward direction, that is called tension in the string. That's why here, the string pulls the block by means of a tension, say that tension is say T. Of course, we consider only the tension here only because it is already pulled by means of a force, okay, by held the block or by pulling the string here, whatever it may be. So the tension of the string here is say T. Tension is always acting away from the block. Suppose if you consider the tension of the string at this block, then the tension is away from the block. If the same tension you consider at this block, then that is away from the block means in this direction. Because whatever the tension of the string, that tension opposes the motion of the block. Because whenever the block moves in this direction, the tension acts on the block away from this motion of the block. That means in this direction. The same tension acts on the block in this direction. Always we have to keep in our mind that the tension is always away from the body. What is the tension of the string when you consider the block here? Means away from the block means in this direction. What is the direction of the tension here? When you consider the block here, then that is away from the block means in this direction. So based on the positions of the block, the direction of the tension depends. Okay, now you see, because of this applied force on the system of two blocks, the two blocks move together along horizontal axis with constant acceleration, say A, towards right. In the case, the force applies to the two blocks, it tells more than it will be. The two blocks are joined in some inextensible string property. Because of application of the force here, with what acceleration this block travel, it also travels with the same acceleration. Because both are joined. That's why both blocks move with the same acceleration. Hence, both blocks can be treated as a single body of mass M1 plus M2. What is the acceleration of system of two blocks? On this system, only one force acts. So because of that force, acceleration of the two blocks together is equal to A is equal to force acts on the system by total mass of the system M1 plus M2. రెండు కలిసి సేమ్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ తో మూవ్ అవుతాయి కాబట్టి రెండు కలిసి సేమ్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ తో మూవ్ అవుతాయి ఎందుకంటే ఇది ఇన్ఎక్స్టెన్సిబుల్ స్ట్రింగ్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఇన్ఎక్స్టెన్సిబుల్ స్ట్రింగ్ విత్ వాట్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ దిస్ బ్లాక్ మూవ్స్ ద స్ట్రింగ్ ఆల్సో పుల్స్ దిస్ బ్లాక్ విత్ ద సేమ్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ ఫార్వర్డ్ యాక్షన్ దట్స్ వై బోత్ బ్లాక్స్ మూవ్ టుగెదర్ హెన్స్ దిస్ టూ బ్లాక్స్ టుగెదర్ కెన్ బి ట్రీటెడ్ యాజ్ ఎ సింగిల్ బాడీ ఆఫ్ మాస్ m1 plus m2 ఓకే ద ఎంటైర్ సిస్టమ్ విల్ మూవ్ విత్ ఎన్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ a బికాజ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ Here the tension between the two blocks, that is the internal force, not external force. On this system, the external force is only F. Of course, here normal action acts in this direction, weight in this direction. Here also normal action, weight in this direction. But they are cancel each other. Because of that reason only, along vertical actions, there are no motions to the two bodies. Okay, now acceleration is this one. Now, what is the tension? Our aim is tension we have to find. Here, even though system is pulled, our system is moved with an acceleration a towards right. This block is pulled by only tension now. Because of this tension acts on this block, as this block travels with acceleration a, what is the tension? Along horizontal direction or along the motion of the block, only the force acts on the block here is tension. Therefore, for block M1, tension P only, the force acts on the block along horizontal direction, due to which the block moves with an acceleration a. That's why T is equal to M1 into acceleration A. Or T is equal to M1 into A means F by M1 plus M. This is the tension in the string. It is the tension force or simply tension in the string. Okay. Similarly, suppose three blocks are there. On a smooth horizontal surface, three blocks are kept. Three blocks are joined by means of inextensible light strings like this, and this block is pulled with a constant force M. Mass of the three blocks are M1, M2, and M3. This block M3 is pulled with a constant force F towards right. Then, of course, all blocks will move together now. All blocks move together. What is Vijay? Because I am unable to unmute all of you now and then, I see and I will unmute. Because if I unmute all of them, our syllabus will not go ahead. That's why now and then I see the chat and I will unmute to clarify your doubts. Okay, Vijay. Yeah, available in Cengage material also. I sent already Cengage material to you. So in that Cengage material, it is available. Vijay, you are unmuting. You are not muting. Sorry, you are unmuting. Even I tried to unmute you, you are not unmuting. Okay. Okay, I will send the classwork to you. Okay, right. Here, three blocks are connected by means of strings, and one block is pulled with a force F. As it is, these all are kept on the smooth horizontal surface. Definitely, because of applied force, however small, because of applied force, entire system will move towards right with constant acceleration or uniform acceleration A, like this. Okay. Now, acceleration A is equal to on the three blocks together. The total force acts on the three blocks together towards right is equal to only F. Of course, here tension is also there. Tension T1 is here. The same tension when you consider this block, tension is away from the block now. Here, it is T2 say that T2 acts in this direction. You see this tension as they are in opposite direction they cancel. Here they cancel. So along horizontal direction, only one force acts on the system of three blocks is F. Because of that force F. The acceleration of the entire system is A. Then A is for F by as three blocks together move with the constant acceleration. The three blocks can be treated as a single body of mass M1 plus M2 plus M3. That's why total mass is M1 plus M2 plus M3. It is the acceleration of the three blocks together. Okay, now here, even though the force of F is applied on this block, this block will move because of this tension only now. So this is only the tension acts on the block towards right to move this block with acceleration A. That's why tension P1 is equal to mass of this block into acceleration A. That is equal to M1 into A means F by M1 plus M2 plus M3. This is T1. Similarly, what about T2? Here, what about T2? We can use this block or this block to find T2. Okay, we can use this one. Here for block M1, okay, for M2. On block M2, along Hardened Collection, what are the forces acts? T2 acts in this direction, T1 acts in this direction. Even then, as this block moves towards right with acceleration A, T2 greater than T1. That's why T2 minus T1 is the net force acts on the block along Hardened Collection towards right. That is equal to mass of the block into acceleration of the block. As all the blocks are having same acceleration, you write like this. Okay? Okay, in case of connected bodies only, we can use these formulas. Connected bodies only, connected by means of strings only, we can use these formulas. Not for contact bodies. Contact bodies are different. Okay? Right. This is equal to M2 into M2 into A means here. Okay, M2 into A means F by M2 into A means F by M1 plus M2 plus M3. Here you see T2 we had to find. T1 already we got T1. Okay. Of course, instead of substituting A directly, we can use like this. Later we can substitute A value. Here T1 means M1 into A. That is equal to M2 A only. Okay, that implies M2 A. So T2 is equal to, you bring this M1 A to right, and you take A common, then you get M1 plus M2 into A. Now you substitute the value. T2 is equal to M1 plus M2 into A means F by M1 plus M2 plus M3. We can write like this. It is the tension D2. In this way, we can find the tensions in the strings. Next. One more example. Okay, next one more example. Example 3 or node point 3. Suppose there is a right angled wedge, fixed wedge. It is the fixed wedge. Okay, so here one pulley is there. One pulley is attached to the fixed wedge like this. Here there is a pulley. Angle of inclination is theta. A light inextensible string is passed over the pulley like this. And at the two ends of the string, two blocks are fixed. Here one block and one block is kept on the smooth inclined surface and the other block is fixed there. Here these blocks are say M1, M2. This is M1, this is M2. Okay, now what about the acceleration of the, what about the tension and what about the acceleration? Okay, here one condition is given. Here, in which the, whenever the system is released like this, here the string passed over the pulley like this, and at this end, one block is fixed, at this end, another block is fixed like this. When the system is released, in which direction the block will move? Here, there is a wedge shaped body, it is fixed. This wedge does not move. Whenever the system is released, in which direction the block will move? Blocks will move. We cannot say directly based on the heavy of the body, heaviness of the body. Okay, stop chatting. Here, suppose if M2 is greater than M1, if M2 is greater than M1, then along which direction the block will move? Blocks will move, tell me. Along inclined plane downwards. Along inclined plane downwards? No. We cannot say, that's why I am telling. Here if M2 greater than M1, we cannot say the two blocks move along the direction of inclined plane like this. If M1 is more, we cannot say the two blocks will move like this. We cannot say. On what factor it depends? Along which direction, you see, along which direction the two blocks will move. The path along which the two blocks will move. The two blocks can move either along this path or along this direction the blocks will move. Along those directions, along that path, whose weight is more, along the direction the two blocks will move. That is the important point you have to remember. Okay? Depends on theta. That's why I asked the question. Here, the two blocks when you release, either the blocks may move along this direction like this or along this path the blocks can move. So that is the direction of motion of the blocks. Along the direction of motion of the blocks, you find the weight components. You find the weight components. Of course, along this path already weight component is M1z. Along the direction of motion of the two blocks, either in this direction or in this direction, weight component is M1z, M1z only. Now, here the weight M2z acts in this direction. Weight component along this direction is equal to, you see, it is normal. If it is theta, this is theta. We know this component is M2z cos theta. Of course, it is M2z. M2z cos theta, this is M2z sin theta. Okay, now along the path along which the two blocks can move, either in this direction or in this direction, M2g sin theta acts in this direction and M1z acts in this direction. Along the path along which the two blocks can move, along that path, these are the two forces only acts. If M2g sin theta greater than M1z, then the two blocks will move like this. If M1z greater than M2g sin theta, then the two blocks will move downwards in this direction. That's why, based on that only, we can say, okay, if M2z sin theta greater than M1z, then definitely, as it is greater, definitely this block will move down. So the total, these two blocks will move like this with an acceleration CA. With what acceleration this is moving like this? With the same acceleration, this block also move upwards because it is the inextensible light stream. It is inextensible light stream property. With what acceleration this block M2 will move down? With the same acceleration, the string pulls the block upwards. That's why A in this direction and A in this direction. Okay, now you apply the Newton's second law of motion for this block, for M1. Suppose here, actually because of weight M1z, the block type comes down. But the string pulls the block in upward direction with a certain force that is called tension of the string. So tension T. Tension T always away from the block. If you consider the pulley, the tension force acts on the pulley due to the string is away from this pulley means in this direction. The same tension acts on the block away from the block means in this direction. Okay. Now for mass M1, for M1, you see along vertical direction on the block two forces act, T upwards and M1z downwards. Even then as the block move upwards means T is greater than M1z, no? So net force acts on the block is equal to T minus M1z. That is equal to M1 into A. Next, for this block M2, here on the block along its direction of motion, M2g sin theta acts along inclined plane downwards and T upwards. Even then, as the block moves downwards, M2g sin theta greater than T, no? So net force is M2g sin theta minus T is equal to mass of that block M2 into acceleration A. Suppose if you want to find the acceleration of the two blocks here, then you add these two. Then when you add these two, then TT cancel. Then M2Z sin theta minus M1Z is equal to sum of these two means M1 plus M2 into A. You see, simply instead of writing these equations to find the acceleration, along the path along which the two blocks will move, that means in this direction the two blocks move. Here in this direction, M2g sin theta acts in this direction and M1z acts on the blocks opposite to their motion. That's why along this path, net force is equal to M2g sin theta minus M1z. That is equal to, because of this net force, as the two blocks to move together with acceleration A. So M2g sin theta minus M1z is equal to M1 plus M2 into A. Directly we can write instead of writing these two equations. Okay. Now, acceleration A is equal to Therefore, from this acceleration A is equal to m2g sin theta, m2g sin theta minus m1g whole by m1 plus m2. Of course, we can take g common. A is equal to m2 sin theta minus m1 into z by m1 plus m2. So this is the acceleration of the system. Acceleration of the two blocks. Okay. What is the tension, they may ask? Then you substitute this A value in this equation or in this equation. Then you find T value. Then you will get the tension. In this way, we can find the tension also. Okay. So from this equation 1, this is a equation 1, it is equation 2, it is 3. 3 in 1 gives, 3 in 1 means from 1, T minus M1Z is equal to M1 into A, or T is equal to M1Z plus M1 into A means M2 sin theta minus M1 of G whole by M1 plus M2. Of course, you simplify them, then you will get answer. This is the formula for tension. In this way, we can find the tension. Okay. Next, one more example here in this case. Shall I write this one? What is your doubt, Vishwa? What is your doubt, Vishwa? Stop your video sharing. Vishwa, now you speak with me.
Sir.
Ask me.
Sir, I have not understood the acceleration derivation.
Acceleration derivation. Are you followed this to these two equations?
Yes, sir.
Just I added these two because we need the formula for acceleration. T should not be there. To eliminate these two, when you add these two equations, T will be cancelled now. Because it is plus T, it is minus T. T will be cancelled. Then remaining is M2G sin theta minus M1G is equal to this plus this. M1 plus M2 into A. A I have taken common. Then yes, I got sir. A value. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right. Right now. Next, one more example. Fourth one. Fourth one, suppose it is also a wedge, fixed wedge. It is the fixed wedge. That means these surfaces does not move. Fixed wedge. It is theta 1, it is say theta 2. Okay, now here there is a pulley. Here there is a pulley. Like this. Pulley. One string is passed over the pulley. Light, it is a light frictionless pulley. One block is fixed here, another block is fixed here like this. Having masses M1 and here it is a M2. When the two blocks are released, of course it is the here the two blocks are kept on the smooth, these are the smooth inclined surfaces, smooth and smooth, here also smooth. Here the two blocks are kept on the smooth inclined surfaces as in the diagram. And they are connected by means of a light inextensible string passed over the light frictionless pulley. Light frictionless pulley. Okay. When the system is released, in which direction the two blocks will move? Of course, we are given the mass of the two blocks M1, M2. Mass of the two blocks are given. In which direction the two blocks will move? Okay, Vamshi Krishna, pulley concept problems are there means we will complete one by one. Tell me. Actually, question paper discussion was not there yesterday for some SARS. They did not complete. But I explained totally now. Last class lo, ninna class lo, paper discussion jarakandi direct ka concepts start chesi direct ka vere cheppesaru problem chepala exam paper lo. Andukane vere SARS complete chestaru. మనం ఇక్కడ ఎగ్జామ్ పేపర్ డిస్కస్ చేసినప్పుడు ఆ బ్యాక్ లాగింగ్ ఉంటుంది కదా ఆ లాగింగ్ ఇప్పుడు ఉంటుంది మళ్ళీ సో ఐ విల్ ట్రై టు మేక్ ఆన్ పార్ విత్ డే సిలబస్ ఓకే depends on angles and masses. Depends on is the system will move in this direction or is the system move in this direction. That depends on the angles and mass of the bodies. Okay. Right. You see, you resolve this weight into components. I don't want to write this component. Okay. Directly I want to write this one only. As it is theta, this component is m2z sin theta 2. Okay. Shall I write like this directly? Actually, the weight m2z acts downwards direction. When you resolve them into components, if it is theta 2, this is theta 2. That's why this component is m2z cos theta 2. It is m2g sin theta 2. Similarly, here also, along this direction, weight component is m1z sin theta 1. Okay. Now, here, whenever the two blocks are released, the two blocks will move along this path or along this path. Along the direction of motion of the two blocks or along the path. What is the net force? Suppose if m2z sin theta 2 or m1z sin theta 1. m1z sin theta 1 is greater than m2z sin theta 2. Say, if this weight component is greater than this one, then the two blocks will move like this along this path. In this direction, we set my acceleration say. As the two blocks are joined by means of inextensible string, then this also move in upward direction along the inclined plane with the same acceleration here. Now, here you see, while this block coming down, at the same time, the string pulls this block upwards with a force equal to tension. As it is the same string, the tension here also same. But on this block, tension acts away from this block. That means in this direction. Okay, now for M1. For M1, what is the net force you tell me? M1g sin theta 1 acts downwards and T upwards. Even then, as this block moves downwards with an acceleration A, then this is greater than this one. That's why net force acts on the block is equal to M1 is equal to M1g sin theta 1 minus M1 into minus T. M1g sin theta 1 minus T is equal to M1 into A. Minus T is equal to M1 into A. For M2, T acts in this direction, M2g sin theta acts downwards. Even then, as this block move upwards, T is greater. That's why T minus M2g sin theta 2 is equal to M2 into A. Now, from these two, in order to obtain acceleration, you add them. Then these two cancel. Then this minus this one. So M1z sin theta 1 minus M2z sin theta 2 is equal to M1A plus M2A. That means M1 plus M2 into A. Or A is equal to, you take Z common here, then M1 sin theta 1 plus M2 sin theta 2 of Z whole by M1 plus M2. In this way, we had to find the acceleration. Suppose if this is greater, M2G sin theta 2 minus T is equal to M2A, T minus M1G sin theta 1 is equal to M1 into A. Then following the same procedure, we can find. What Siddharth? What is wrong with the answer? Siddharth.
Sir, if you take G common, M1 sin theta minus M2 sin theta will come now, sir.
Okay. Minus is there. Okay. Minus. Right. Here only minus is there. This is minus. Okay. Okay. Right now. Okay, thank you. Right. This is the formula for acceleration. You substitute this A value in this equation. Suppose this is say equation 1, equation 2. In 1 or 2, you substitute the acceleration value from 3 in any one of these two equations, 1 or 2, then you will get the tension value. Then we can find the tension. Substitute A value in 1 or 2 and find T. Okay. Of course, from 1, M1z sin theta 1 minus T is equal to M1 into A. Or T is equal to M1z sin theta 1 minus M1a is equal to T. Or M1z sin theta 1 minus M1 into A means this one. m1 sin theta 1 minus m2 sin theta 2, okay, whole by m1 plus m2 of g. This is the formula for tension. Of course, we cannot remember the formulas. We have to do by concept only. Okay, this is one more concept. So, in this way, in case of connected bodies, we can do. Next, sometimes they may ask. Sometimes they may ask. Fifth one. M1, M2, M3. Okay. Tension here is T1. Of course, same tension T1 acts here, T2. Same tension acts in this direction. Okay. Now, here the force, here the third block is pulled with a force F by making an angle theta with the horizontal. At the instant, you listen problem carefully. At the instant, whenever the block M3, here the force F is gradually increasing. And at the instant, whenever the block, the normal reaction acts on the block becomes zero, what is the tension of the string here and here, they may ask. What is the tension of the string here and here? They may ask like that. At the instant, whenever normal reaction, or at the instant, whenever normal reaction zero means it loses contact with floor. It loses contact with the floor. At the time, normal reaction acts on this block is zero. At the time, what is the tension here and here, they may ask. Are you followed the question first? Are you followed the question? Ikkada chudandi F force ni pai apply chesamandi. Then here, what are the force acts on the block means? No doubt, the force component F cos theta acts in this direction and F sin theta acts in this direction. Weight M3z acts vertically downwards direction. Okay, so here at the instant here, because net force M through Z, M3Z minus F sin theta acts on the block downwards. It is still in contact with them. Then normal action is in upward direction of N3. On the first, third block, normal action say N3. Then what is the normal action here? Normal reaction N3 is equal to, we can write M3Z minus F sin theta. No? M3Z minus F sin theta. So at the instant, whenever it loses contact with the floor, at the instant, whenever the third block loses contact with the floor, at that time, what is the tension here and here? They may ask like that. So, in advance, they may ask like that. At the instant, when M3 lose contact with floor, then T1 is equal to, okay, at the instant whenever M3 lose contact with the floor, what is the condition? Tell me. When the M3 block loses contact with the floor, at that time, what is the condition? When it loses contact means no normal action. Normal action is zero, no? That's why M3 is equal to zero. If contact lose out on the end, normal action will not take it. So M3 is equal to zero. M3 is equal to zero means that implies M3z is equal to F sin theta, or that implies F is equal to M3Z by sin theta. That means indirectly by this condition, F is given. When you know F, then because of F cross theta only, the entire system will move towards right. So from this F we calculated. Then because of this F cross theta only, the entire system will move towards right. Therefore, what is the acceleration of the system? Acceleration of the system along horizontal axis is equal to net force acts on the system along horizontal axis equal to F cross theta only along the direction of motion. This tension, tension cancel here. These are the internal forces. They cancel each other. Only along horizontal action, the external force acts on the system of three blocks is equal to F cross theta only along the direction of motion. That's why acceleration is equal to net force acts on the system F cross theta by total mass of the system M1 plus M2 plus M3. I think now here F can be calculated from this formula. Acceleration can be calculated by this formula. Now, what is the tension means? Here, this block is pulled. Suppose the entire system will move with an acceleration A like this. Okay, then this tension only pulls the block in this direction. That's why tension T1 is equal to mass of the block into acceleration A. A means of course F cross theta by something. Similarly, whatever tension here, T2, here on this block M2, on the block M2, on M2, you see, T1 acts in this direction, T2 in this direction. Even then, as the block moves in this direction with acceleration A, T2 greater than T1. That's why net force is equal to T2 minus T1. That is equal to mass of the block M2 into acceleration A. So T2 is equal to T1 plus M2 into A. T1 means from this formula, M1 into A. No? T1 is equal to M1 into A plus M2 into A. Therefore, M1 plus M2 into A. A means that formula we had to use. Therefore, T2 is equal to M1 plus M2 into A means F cos theta by M1 plus M2 plus M3. Similarly, T1 is equal to already M1A, no? M1A. That is equal to M1 into A means F cos theta by M1 plus M2 plus M3. These are the tensions in the two strings. In this way, we have to calculate. Here, tensions are calculated at the instant whenever the block ready to leave contact with the flow. At that time, whatever the tension, that is the condition. Based on that condition, I calculate the tensions in the string. Okay, this type of question once, not this problem, this type of model, they ask it once in advance. So that is important. Okay, next step. Sixth one, in the tension only, suppose there is a uniform rope, here there is a uniform rope. Like tug of war, uniform rope or tug of war, we can say. Okay. Where is F cos theta? No, after simplification, whatever the value you will get, I did not simplify. Okay, I did not simplify them. Directly I wrote, if you simplify them, whatever the value you will get, you will get. Okay, right. Here once, uniform rope is kept on a smooth horizontal flow or it is a tug of war. Two teams pulls this rope in this direction with a force F1, in this direction with a force F2. In a tug of war, two teams pulls the rope exact in opposite directions with equal forces, not equal, F1, F2. Okay, now the length of the rope is say L. The length of the rope is L. From the end where F1 force is applied at a distance x, that means at exactly from the end where F1 force is applied at a distance x, what is the tension in the rope? T is equal to question mark. That is the case. If, of course, based on the given values, we know is F1 is greater or F2 is greater, we know. Suppose F1 greater than F2, then in which direction the rope will move? It may be tug of war or it may be a rope kept on the smooth horizontal surface and it is pulled with forces F1, F2 in opposite directions. If F1 greater than F2, then definitely the rope will move in this direction of its acceleration A. Then what is that acceleration means? Net force acts on the rope in this direction is equal to F1 minus F2. That is equal to mass of the rope M, mass of the rope is say M, into acceleration A. That implies acceleration is equal to F1 minus F2 by mass of the rope. It is equation 1. What is the tension of the rope at this point? That is the question they asked. Just I will draw free body diagram of this part of the rope only. This is say A, B, it is a point C. So just I am drawing the part BC only. it is B, it is C. The length of this path is X. Okay. As the entire rope will travel with an acceleration A towards right, definitely every part of the rope also travel with the same acceleration towards right. No, that's why this path also travels towards right. Okay, now it is this N is pulled with a force F1 in this direction. Here, when you consider this path pulls this part in this direction by applying some force here. That is called the tension. The force with which this part of the rope pulls this part in this direction, that is the tension of the rope at this point. Here the tension is always acting away from the body. Suppose if you consider this part, tension at this point is acting away from the body, means in this direction. If you consider the same tension acts on this body, that is away from this part, means in this direction. So for this part, the tension is in this direction. So along the direction of motion of the rope or this part of the rope, there are two forces acts, F1 and T. Even then, as the rope travels towards right, each and every part also travels towards right only. That's why it travels towards right. Hence, F1 greater than T. No? Therefore, net force acts on the rope is equal to F1 minus T. That is equal to mass of this part of the rope into acceleration. What is the mass of this part of the rope? Okay. Total mass of the rope is M, length L. Then what is the mass per unit length? M by L. If M by L is the mass per unit length of this rope, for this length, what is the mass means into X? It is the mass of this part of the rope into acceleration A. Okay. Therefore, F1 minus T is equal to M by L into X into A means F1 minus F2 by M. Now we take, okay, T we had find out. Therefore, T is equal to F1 minus, you bring this T on to, towards right and remaining part towards left. Then F1 minus, here mm cancel. No? Then F1 minus X by L into F1 minus F2. Okay, therefore T is equal to F1 minus X into F1 by L minus of minus plus. This is minus, no, minus of minus plus F2 by L. Therefore, you take F1 common is F1 of 1 minus X by L plus F2 by L. This is the formula for tension in the rope, where X is the distance of the length of the rope, distance of the length, distance of the point from the end where F1 force is applied. From the end where F1 force is applied. Sometimes you will be given this length as X. This length as X and F1 greater than F2. Then what about X now? This X becomes L minus X now, that is X. Instead of L minus X, we have to write this value. This value. Sometimes you are given this length. Then what about X means? X value is equal to L minus X, we have to write here. If it is given as X, okay, then what is this value means? L minus X. Then you have substitute, instead of X, we have substitute L minus X. By considering this end, the point at a distance X from this end where F1 force is applied, we got the formula like this. If at this point, from this point at a distance X, what is the tension? If they ask like that, if it is X, this is L minus X, no? That's why instead of X, you substitute L minus X. You will get answer. Okay? Next, if the rope is kept on the smooth horizontal floor like this, the rope is kept on the smooth horizontal floor, and it is pulled by means of applying force F1 is equal to F, like this one. What is the acceleration? And what is the, okay, in this case, what is the tension? Not acceleration, tension. From the end where force is applied at a distance X, what is the tension that's taking? That is the case. Same method, but F2 is not there. F1 is equal to F. You put F2 is equal to 0, and F is equal, F1 is equal to F, you put it here. Then tension here is equal to, how you can write? Tension is equal to F1 means F into 1 minus X by L. F2 is 0 because nobody is applying force here. Okay, that's why tension is 0. Shall I do like this only or shall I write directly for this? With the help of this formula, we can write directly what is the tension of the string. Or shall I do totally? Last three steps. Here, from this formula, I brought T to right. Then T is equal to, I brought this term to left. F1 minus of X by L into F1 minus F2. MM cancel now. X by L into F1 minus F2. Then minus of X by L into F1 minus minus plus X by L into F2. X by L in, it is x by L into F2, no? It is x of, okay, it is x. It is x is there, no, here. X is there here also. Okay, very good. Very good now. Okay, right, right. Here now, in this case, in this rope, when it is pulled with a force F, then what is the tension of the rope at the end where force is applied? Where the force is applied. Okay. In this case, okay, we will derive. Because of application of this force, as the entire rope travels with an acceleration A, say, okay, then acceleration A is equal to, it is say, 100.7. A is equal to F by total mass is M. Length of the rope is L and mass is say M. Then what is the tension here? Means you consider this part of the rope only. So you consider small part. BC. Length X. Okay. Here, as the entire rope will travel towards right, this part of the rope also travel towards right. Here on this part, at this end, applied force F acts in this direction. And tension in this, at this point always acts away from this part, means in this direction. Suppose you consider the tension for this part. For this part, if tension is away from this one, your tension in this direction, tension in this direction. If you consider this part, tension here, we have take this one. If you consider this part, tension is in this direction. Okay, as two forces acts on this part, even then as this part traveling in this direction along with the entire rope, then this is greater than this one. So F minus T is equal to mass of this part into acceleration. What is the mass of this part? M dash into acceleration. What is M dash? Mass per unit length is M by L now. Then for this much length, what is the acceleration? What is the mass means? M by L into X. Into A means F by M. So MM cancel. That is equal to X into F by L. Therefore, tension T is equal to F minus. I brought this, I move this minus T to right and XF by L towards left. To left. Then F minus XF by L. That is equal to F of 1 minus X by L. This is the formula for tension. Tension in the rope. Of course, even F2 is equal to 0, you put here. Then F1 is equal to F. F into 1 minus X by L. I got the same. That's why in this way you will get. Okay. This is the rope concept. Suppose if the rope is pulled by two teams. In tug of war, the rope is pulled by the two teams with equal forces, so that the rope does not move in any direction. In such case, what is the tension? So, if rope is pulled with equal forces on both sides, once it was given in mains, the rope is pulled with equal forces like this. The question may be asked like this, or suppose one end of the rope is fixed to the rigid support, the other end is pulled with a force F. In that, this case or this case, both are same. Because when this end of the rope is pulled with a force F, then definitely the rigid support also pulls this end of the rope in opposite direction with the same force. Then only it will be held with the rigid support. Otherwise, there is no question of, there is no fixing of this rope to this rigid wall. Okay? This case or this case, both are same. Here, F1 is equal to F2 is equal to same F. Now use this formula. At an end, from this end, at a distance x, what is the tension in the rope? So from that formula, T is equal to F1 into 1 minus x by L plus x into F2 by L. Okay, as F1 and F2 both are same, instead of F1 and F2, you write F1. F into 1 minus x by L plus x into F by L. Here, this is equal to F minus Fx by L plus Fx by L or Xf by L. These two cancel now. Therefore, tension is equal to F. That means whenever the rope is pulled with two equal forces exactly in opposite direction, then tension in the string at this distance x from this end does not depend on the distance of the point from this end. At any point here in the rope, the tension remains same. So in the tug-off part, when two teams pulls the rope in opposite directions with equal forces, then tension at every point in the rope remains same. So therefore, in this case, tension at every point remains same. Tension at every point remains same. and equal to, most of the students at the time they did mistake that when two forces act, two equal forces act on group exactly in opposite direction, at any point what is the tension means, just in most of the students did write 2F. It is not 2F, equal to one of the forces only, equal to one of the forces. That is very, very important, one of the forces. So this is the rope concept, tension concept. Next, pulley concept. Adward mission. Varshit Reddy, you are asking pulley frequently. So now I will say your task, pulley concept. Next, what is the point I have completed now? Eighth one completed now. Eighth point is completed now. Yeah, now ninth point I have to say. Atwood mission. Our pulley concept. Suppose there is a light pulley. There is a light pulley fixed to rigid supports. It is a light pulley. Mass is negligible. Okay. Frictionless light pulley. A string is passed over the light pulley. Like this. And at the two ends of the rope, one block is fixed here. Another block is fixed here. Okay, suppose here M2 greater than M1, I have considered. Now, the weight of this block M1Z acts downwards direction here, M2Z acts downwards direction. Okay, now, you see whenever the two blocks are released, obviously as M2 greater than M1, definitely this M2 block will come down and M1 will rise up. Suppose the M2 block comes down with an acceleration, say A. As this block is connected by means of inextensible light string, this block also move with the same acceleration as block M2, but in upward direction. So here, with acceleration A, it move upward direction. Here you see, whenever the weight of the block M1Z acts downwards direction, even as this block is moved upwards, means the string pulls this block upwards. So the force with which the string pulls the block upwards. Upwards is called the tension in the string. Okay, the same string is there. That's why tension in the string is also same. The same tension acts on this because it is the light inextensible string. As it is the light string, the tension at every point remains same. If the string is not light, if weight of the string is also considerable, in such cases, tension at different points are different. The weight of the string is to be considered to find the tension, but it is the light string. It is the light string. Okay, now the tension is also same. Whatever the tension here, at this point also tension is same. Now you see, for block M1, here on the block, along vertical action, two forces acts. T upwards, M1G downwards. Even then, as the block M1 move upwards, then T greater than M1Z. That's why net force acts on the block upwards is T minus M1Z. That is equal to M1 into A. This is equation 1. For M2, here M2Z acts downwards, T upwards. Even then, as the block M2 comes down, M2Z greater than T. That's why net force is M2Z minus T. That is equal to M2 into acceleration A, according to Newton's second law. Now, to find acceleration, add these two. When you add these two, then T will be cancelled. Then M2Z minus M1Z is equal to M2 plus M1 into A. Because M2A plus M1A, we can take A common. Here you take G common, M2 minus M1 into Z is equal to M2 plus M1 into A. Or acceleration A is equal to M2 minus M1 into Z by M2 plus M1. If M1 is greater, M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into Z we have to write, if M2 is greater. In such case, this block comes down and this block rises up. Okay, now in this case, acceleration is this one. What about the tension? You substitute this A value in any one of the equations from 1. minus m1z is equal to m1 into a. So t minus m1z is equal to m1 into a means m2 minus m1 by m2 plus m1 into c. Now t is equal to, you bring this m1z, you write m1z to right, m1z plus m1 into m2 minus m1 by m2 plus m1 into c. In both the terms you take m1z common, here m1z is there, here m1z is there, you take common m1z of 1 plus m2 minus m1 by m2 plus m1, m1z into, when you take LCM, m2 plus m1, m2 minus m1, minus m1 plus m1 cancel, 2m2 is there, 2m2 by m1 plus m2. Therefore, tension P is equal to 2m1 m2 z by m1 plus m2, 2m1 m2 z by m1 plus m2. This is the tension. This is the tension, the string here. It is the outward mission. With the help of this outward mission, with the help of this outward mission, they find the acceleration of the block, and m1 and m2 are known. They find the acceleration of the block experimentally. Then g can be calculated, you know. So with the help of the outward mission, we can find the acceleration due to gravity at that place also. Okay, I will send the notes to you. Okay, now the time is 12:50. Last point. Okay, here you see, this is the tension. Suppose if you consider the pulley, the tension due to string acts on the pulley, away from the pulley means in this direction, here also away from the pulley means in this direction. With this tension T plus T, with this 2T force, the string pulls the pulley in downwards direction. At the same time, this support on the pulley, support of the pulley pulls the pulley in upward direction with certain force, that is the thrust on the pulley, thrust, F thrust. So therefore, even then, thrust on the pulley acts upwards and 2T downwards, even then there is no motion in the pulley. That's why thrust is equal to 2T. Therefore, thrust on the pulley, last point, thrust on the pulley, thrust on pulley is equal to F thrust, that is equal to 2T. So thrust on the pulley, F thrust is equal to 2 into T means 2M1, M2 by Z by M1 plus M2. Therefore, thrust on the pulley is equal to 4m1 m2 z by m1 plus m2. This is the thrust on the pulley. Okay. Thrust means it is a force here. Thrust on the pulley means the reaction force exerted by support on the pulley. That, of course, in different cases we use that term. Reaction force acts on the pulley upwards. That is the thrust on the pulley here. Thrust means reaction force. Okay. Right. Here, what every day, whatever the assignment or whatever the notes, whatever the homework problems you have to do, we will send in these 2 days. Of course, we will send in WhatsApp group, we will keep in WhatsApp group, and at the same time in Google class work, in Google class also. Google class are there, no? Already in chemistry, I think mathematics you opened Google classroom. In already, I sent the Google classroom code to you. My Google Classroom code I sent to you. Already sent it. Okay. Our Google Classroom code me already send jese andi. Already it is sent. Okay. Our Google Classwork open jese. Me dantlo e ne pampichana code ni ganaka open jese directly Sri Chakra China Batch 2 ani vastundi. Sri Chakra China Batch 2. Dantlo nenu chesina posting chesina assignment gaani notes gaani everything will be available there. అయితే ఇది ఎందుకు ఇంట్రొడ్యూస్ చేశారంటే వాట్సాప్ లో సపోజ్ నేను ఒక అసైన్మెంట్ పెట్టానండి, ఒక సపోజ్ ఈ టైంలో పోస్ట్ చేశాను, ఆ తర్వాత నెక్స్ట్ టైంలో నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ లో వేరే వాళ్ళు పోస్ట్ చేశారు అనుకోండి, ఈ నేను పెట్టిన పోస్టింగ్ మొత్తం పైకి వెళ్ళిపోతుంటుంది, మనకు కనిపిస్తుంది సరిగా నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ పోస్టింగ్స్ వస్తాయి కాబట్టి. దట్ ఈస్ ద మేజర్ డ్రాబ్యాక్ ఇన్ వాట్సాప్ గ్రూప్. దట్స్ వై దే ఇంట్రొడ్యూస్డ్ గూగుల్ క్లాస్ వర్క్. ఓకే, ఇన్ దిస్ 2 డేస్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ట్రయల్ రన్. అంటే 2 డేస్ లో ఇవాళ రేపు ట్రయల్ అని చూద్దాం ఎట్లా ఉంది, దాని వల్ల మనకి బెనిఫిట్ ఉందా లేదా. ఆ గూగుల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ లో మనం పోస్ట్ చేసిన అన్ని కూడా ఒకే ప్లేస్ లో ఉంటాయి, ఎటు షిఫ్ట్ కావు, అవే ప్లేస్ లో ఉంటే మనం వెరిఫై చేసుకోవడం కూడా ఈజీనే ఫ్యూచర్ లో. మనం వెరిఫై చేసి ఆల్రెడీ ఐ సెంట్ ద కోడ్ టు యు. ఓకే, సో మనం సెండ్ చేసిన ఈ అఫ్కోర్స్ ఇవన్నీ మీకు ఆల్రెడీ పంపించానండి కోడ్ అవన్నీ కూడా, అవి ఓపెన్ చేసుకోండి, దాంట్లో అసైన్మెంట్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఓకే, ఇవాళ రేపు ట్రయల్ అని చూద్దాం, సక్సెస్ఫుల్ గా జరిగితే రేపు థర్స్డే నుంచి ఇంకా కంప్లీట్ గా గూగుల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ లోనే వర్క్ చేద్దాం. అయితే దాని కోడ్ వచ్చేసరికి మీకు ఆల్రెడీ వాట్సాప్ లో పెట్టాను అన్న. ఓకే, మీ కోడ్ వచ్చేసరికి చూడండి ఒకసారి, గూగుల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ కోడ్ చూసి U6IOZUS. This is your Google Classroom code. This is your Google Classroom code. U6IOGUS. It is your Google Classroom code. మీరు దాన్ని ఓపెన్ చేస్తే నేను పెట్టే అసైన్మెంట్స్ కానీ అవన్నీ కూడా దాంట్లో ఉంటాయి. ఓకే, టుడే ఐ విల్ పోస్ట్ ఇన్ దట్ గూగుల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్. ఓకేనా? రైట్. Right now. Okay. Have a nice day. Bye. Right. I am signing out. What, Varshit Reddy? What is your doubts? Varshit Reddy. జాక్ స్పారో, మీ పేర్లు పెట్టున్నానా? జాక్ స్పారో అవి ఇవి పెట్టట్లా ఉన్నాయి కదా మీకు పేర్లు. Varshit, Jack Sparrow, you are not unmuting. Okay, Varshit Reddy, what is your doubts? Varshit Reddy. Okay, sir, you are unmuted. Ask.
Sir, akkada adi pulle ki surface nunchi ave povali kabatti pulle nunchi ave isukunnara sir, tension akkada endu
enana pulle
ma tension surface ka ave aagutadu annara sir,
away from the body. ఇక్కడ స్ట్రింగ్ తీసినప్పుడు దీని వల్ల దీని మీద పనిచేసే ఫోర్స్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ ది బాడీ మీన్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్ ఓన్లీ నో. సిమిలర్లీ హియర్ ఆల్సో బికాజ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ టెన్షన్ ఇన్ ద స్ట్రింగ్ యాక్ట్స్ ఆన్ దిస్ బాడీ ఆర్ దిస్ పుల్లీ ఇస్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ ది పుల్లీ మీన్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్. ఫర్ ది బ్లాక్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ ది బ్లాక్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్. ఓకే
సార్, ఒకవేళ పుల్లి కూడా కిందకి పోతుంటే ఎఫ్ థ్రస్ట్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2t కాదు కదా సార్?
ఏనానా పుల్లి
కూడా కిందకి పోతుంటే సార్
ఆ
2t ఎఫ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2t కాదు కదా సార్?
అప్పుడు పైన ఫోర్స్ కూడా ఏదో ఉంటుంది కదా. ఇది 2t కాన్స్టెంట్ ఏ 2t ఏ మార్దు కాదా, 2t t వాల్యూ మే డిక్రీస్ వైల్ ద పుల్లీ కమ్స్ డౌన్.
ఓకే సార్,
ఆ t వాల్యూ ఇక్కడ ఎంత ఉంటుందో ఇక్కడ ఎంత ఉంటుంది అదే మార్దు. ఓకే, ఐ సీ. ఫిక్స్డ్ గా ఉన్నప్పుడు టెన్షన్ ఒకే విధంగా ఉంటుంది, వెన్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఇన్ మోషన్ ద టెన్షన్ విల్ బి డిఫరెంట్.
ఓకే సార, టెన్షన్ డిఫరెంట్ అంటే రూపం ఎక్కడ డిఫరెంట్ సార్?
అంటే మనకి ఇంకో పుల్లీ కూడా ఉంటుంది ఇక్కడ యాడ్ చేసాయి, నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ లో వస్తాయి, అవి డిస్కస్ చేద్దాం. ఓకే
సార్, సార్ ఇంకా ఇంకా చెప్తారు కదా సార్ నోట్ పాయింట్స్?
ఆ ఇంకా ఉన్నాయి, కొన్ని నోట్ పాయింట్స్ ఉన్నాయి ఇంకా.
ఓకే సార్,
అంటే రిలేటెడ్ టు పుల్లీ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఓన్లీ, సమ్ మోర్ నోట్ పాయింట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, కన్స్టెంట్ రిలేషన్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో దేర్. టుమారో కన్స్టెంట్ రిలేషన్స్, సమ్ పుల్లీ పాయింట్ పుల్లీ కాన్సెప్ట్, కన్స్టెంట్ రిలేషన్ అండ్ కాంటాక్ట్ బాడీస్ వి హావ్ టు డిస్కస్. ఓకే
ఓకే సార్, ఓకే సార్, థాంక్యూ సార్,
బై. ఓకే నా, ఐ యామ్ సైనింగ్ అవుట్. జాక్ స్పారో, జాక్ స్పారో ఆర్ యు ఆన్లైన్?